Hi everyone, this is Patty. I'm here today with a Country Craft Creations design team project. And what I did, and you've seen me do this many times before, I took all the leftovers I had by the 12 by 12 collection to the Metropolitan Girl that Tammy Merrill had sent me. You know, I made that the mini album out of that, and I'll link below to the mini album if you haven't seen it. But I had a lot of leftovers, so I decided again I would make cards. And I used the Country Craft Creations Artisan Cardstock. I've used all different colors in this. They're just a few oddball colors that I pulled out of my stash. If you have not used this, and I know I preach it in every single video, you must try it. Get the sampler pack. That's 24 sheets. I think it gives you 6 different colors, and that'll give you a chance to try it. But this stuff is fantastic for card making or mini album making. What I've done is I got 15 cards this time, and I haven't used, you can see, I still have quite a bit of the 6x6 book. I'm just going to put it back. I think that I can incorporate this in with some other lines and make something down the road. So let's just go through, and I'll try not to spend a whole lot of time so you're not here all day with me, but I'm not going to do how-to processes, but I'm going to give you hints and tips as I go through. Now, this is one of my favorites because I love these little boots, which I cut a fussy cut from the 12x12 paper. I used a Martha Stewart punch. This is the Monarch butterfly punch, and I use this, and I punch the butterfly 3 times on a solid coral. There, solid coral. This is this, but just the back side of it. Then I put a ribbon through it and a pearl. And what this page was is I had cut out with my scalloped, I think these are Fiskars. Yeah, I think these are Fiskars, the old Fiskars scallop. If you're gonna if you don't have one and you want a scallop, I wouldn't recommend these type. They're older. They're really wonky, and I've had a lot of them break on me. Anyway, I had this piece laying here. This was the what do you call it? The negative. So I just cut it out. I put some Heartfelt Creations. This is the clear cardstock, and I don't know if Tammy sells this in the store. If she doesn't, you can use any type of clear cardstock, even leftover packaging. And I just put some bits in it, but I still didn't like it. That's why I added the butterflies. These are all A2 size cards. They are cut by this is the card basis that I use. I like to have, if I'm going to do multiple cards, I like to have a bunch of them ready in a various colors, and especially white or cream, because that's usually my base. This is a standard A2 size, which when folded is 4.25 by 5.5. Okay, so on the inside, I just took one of the, this is the edge pieces on the top of your paper. And I used it, and it says, at my age, you must be kidding. And this was just a cut apart from the paper. I used this stamp set. And if you like the retro 50s look, if you can find this stamp set, it's a Wendy Vecchie stamp set from Stampers Anonymous. Oh, my word, it has some great sayings. You'll see as we go forward. So that's my first card. Here's my next one. This, again, is using the Wendy Vecchie set. I'm trying to keep the glare off of it, and it's these two little gals and some of the sayings. And what this is just one of the cut pieces that have the sayings in it. I stamped mine with embossing powder on it. I put it in the middle, and then I scored each angle and drew into it to give that illusion of a shadow box. These are paper from the collection, and again, I just used my scallop punch. I put a brad in the middle. I ran them through pine needles, this green, because it seemed to be a good green for this. Just dampened them all, the sheets, around sheets, and then scrunched them up, ran them through that, put the brad in the middle and let them dry. And they're really crispy critters now. And I have a couple little ones. This is 3 layers. These are 1 layer. This is from the collection. And on this one, I did use my corner rounder and rounded the corners. And here's the inside. I was almost to the end of my paper line when I did this one. Then this one, I did use the strip from the 6x6. This is another saying from that same set. I did use some embossing powders on this one. This back embossing powder is Pearls. It's a Marianne design. It's a great, well, you can see better here. It's a great embossing folder. I love it. I just popped this up. There's a little piece of chipboard behind so I could stick my little girls behind. And I fussy cut them out and the bow so the bow can always stick over the top for that dimensional look. Here's the inside. This is one of the chipboard pieces and I had the little heart in my stash. Here's another one of the ones that is the scene, and I left this open so I could put a gift card in here, or what money, or whatever, and it says, out of my way, I have my sassy britches on. I think this was one of the very last cards I made, so I was really getting down to the nitty gritty. And I've inked all the way around. This is just some scraps from the paper and a little bow from my stash. These are from the sticker sheet, and I just used some Wink of Stella and some, I used on this just some crystal glitter, just sprinkled it over the top. I'm not a real good glitter fan because it goes everywhere. Here's another one, and I believe I left this open so you could put a gift card or anything else in here. Here's one of the girls from the stamp set, and again, if you didn't want it on the front, you could put it on the inside. And a stamp from the set, and I don't like the stamps just stamped down. I have a real hard time. I think I'm going to go back and put the glitter on these. This is from the ephemera package, the shop, and there you can see the Wink of Stella. I used Wink of Stella in clear throughout my book. I love it. Again, this is embossed with this is stamped with Faded Jeans Distress Ink. And then as soon as it stamps, or as soon as it's done, then I sprinkle it with clear embossing ink and go over the top. I love that effect. And this is the other stamp set I use. This is Delusions. This is a Dylan Riverly. I love her stuff. It says, Say It How It Is. Another great, great, if you have a warped kind of sense of humor, depending on who you're going to be giving these to. And then here's the inside. And on this one, I used, this I got at Tuesday Morning for, I think, 99 cents a bottle. And now I wish I bought all they had. This is by Eileen's. It's a paper glaze. It's a great product. It goes on very milky. But as you can see, it's shiny, but it's not real raised, and it has a different look than what your glossy accents or your 3D crystal lacquer has. So well worth having in your arsenal, especially if you can get it for that cheap price. Here's the next one. This one I have just strung three of the stickers backed with black, with the black seam binding from the store. Here it is. My sister sent me, or gave me, oh my word, oodles and oodles of these Blue Moon charms that she got in a grab bag. She bought me one grab bag and then she went back and got me another grab bag. So that's what the tassel is. And then here's the inside. I always like to have something on the inside to kind of finish it off. Here's the next one. This is the Lifestyle Crafts Dainty Swirls. You can see maybe here. There we are. And that's what the background is here. Strips of the paper, one of the pieces of chipboard, and here's the inside. This one is with a Cuddlebug, an old Cuddlebug folder that was Swiss Dots is what this is, and you can see the dots there. And she's just stuck in back behind. This is, again, one of those stamps that I cut out, and I cut the pieces apart, so I have currently unsupervised. The possibilities are endless. This was the very last card I did last night because I had these scraps. So you've seen me do this piecework part before, but I just love how it looks. And I may go back and put something else on the front. It says, mostly I just sit around all day being fabulous. And I did do Wink of Stella on this. This is Distress Ink, so it's kind of got a distressy kind of look to it. And then I went back with, I think, 3D Crystal Lacquer on that last night. Here's another one. This is one of the ephemera pieces on a blue circle, on a scalloped polka dot circle. Here you can see it, and then on a doily. And this is one of the ephemera pieces, and it just has Wink of Stella, and I think that I put 3D crystal lacquer on this one. This one I did punch out a little piece of the acetate and put it over the top, and on the ring of on the outside is just your 3D crystal lacquer. And here's the inside. These glasses are from the sticker set as well, and I just put glossy accents in the middle. This one I had a harder time with because I had this piece from the 6x6 collection, but I didn't want to cover any of it up, but I didn't just want to slap a plain piece down. So I got out, this is Doodlebug, and this is Flocking. My daughter got it for me eons ago, and I tell you, use it and use it and use it, and it barely looks like you've done anything. So I have flocked the trees. See if I can get it there for you. Flock the tree, three trees in green and then brown, and then the taxi cabs are done with either glossy accents or 3D crystal lacquer. These are three chipboard pieces and a piece from the sticker selection. Oh, and I forgot to get this. This is the Island Mist Pearlescence with just some red stickles in it for her, the bow in her hair, and the pearlescence earrings on. I love that pearlescence stuff. That's by Bow Bunny. And here's this one. Chipboard piece, sticker piece, leftovers, some of the grosgrain ribbon. And then when you open it up, oh, and I had to put a backing on this one because I had ink sitting somewhere and I got black marks. But don't despair. If you do something like that, add another piece of paper to it. It just makes your card that much more sturdier. And then again, I tap the little girl behind the thing, the reptile girl, and there is a pop dot right there, so she's not flush. She kind of has some dimension. This one, again, I used some of these mini bags from a Canvas Core Home Basics, and I also used Glimmer Mist and Simply Sheer. This is a matte, doesn't have any sheen. This one has sheen in the crimson and the rose red, because that way it matches. And this is for, again, a gift card to stick in there, or money, or whatever you want. And here's the inside. This is another saying from that retro one, the gossiping one. Cute. And then the last one here is I am currently unsupervised. Now, can you see how her hair is done on this one? This is black stickles. And the thing, if you want to do like a hair that has texture on it, just keep dabbing it up and down. Don't smear it around. Just dab it up and down. And if you still don't have enough texture, kind of tap it a little bit with your fingertip and you'll get that. These are all cut out, fussy cut from the paper collection, and they're popped up, so the bags are all around her. I even fussy cut in the middle. Now, I did use the paper glaze on them, so it makes them real sturdy. And I used foam tape, chipboard, and the art glitter glue throughout in my cards. And here's the inside. So here are my cards. What do you think, guys? For just using up the scraps that were that I had left over on my table, I think I came out with quite a few neat cards. They're not real involved because, like I said, they're just using up what I had laying around. Now, I did use some borders on them. I used the Eyelet border from EK Success, the Deco Scallop border from EK Success, and the postage stamp from EK Success. I also used a Stamping Up white embossing powder, Whispers clear embossing powder, and Stampendous of black. I think this is black, detail black. Those are the embossing powders I used. So there you go. I hope that gives you an idea of making some cards with your leftover scraps, because I know what I'm like. Once I put that bag back in the cupboard and away, I rarely get it back out. I might as well do everything now and use up everything I want to use. And all I tossed were some few ins and outs, you know, just little pieces here and there. So thanks for watching. Have a very crafty day. Get out your scraps from one of your craft projects that you finished up and you still have a bag of scraps, and sit down and make you a whole set of cards. Have your mats, your base card bases ready. Have any elements that you might, some punches, some, just get everything ready, and that way you won't get frustrated and you'll just zoom right through. Thanks for watching, everyone. Have a great crafty day. Until I see you next time, be sure and check out Country Craft Creations. The store link will be below. And also, don't forget to check out the scrapbook, Scrapbookers of Country Craft Creations, the Facebook group. There are lots of free tutorials and an overabundance of crafty inspiration and knowledge and education flowing through that group page. So bye for now.